So let's start with today's lesson. Today's date is 15th of March. 15th of March. Tomorrow we have to start a new chapter from book 2. As I informed you before.
Okay, ma'am.
So did you arrange your that chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Exercise number 5E. This is the last exercise of this chapter. This is at your book page number. Yes, boys, book page number 137.
137.
Okay, what is the topic for this exercise?
Money exchange.
Money exchange. What do you mean by money exchange? That you are exchanging money with your friends or something else?
Money exchange means that if it is in rupees, that the money is in rupees, and if you want to you can convert it.
Abdul Rahman, there is some problem with your internet. We can't hear you properly. Anyone else?
Now can you hear me?
No, it's not. Voice is not clear. Yes, boys. So money exchange means, what do you mean? I explained to you yesterday about money exchange. What do you mean by money exchange?
Ma'am, exchange of money from one currency to another.
Yes, exchanging of the currency. Money exchange means exchanging of the currency, that you, like you are exchanging the reals to rupees, or dollars to the to reals, or dollars to rupees. This is called the money exchange. So we have done yesterday the question number 1, 2, 3. Question number 1, 2, 3 we completed yesterday. Today we have to start from question number 4. So everyone, please be active in the class. I can call any boy to read the question. Your book should be with you. And I will not listen any excuse that I don't have book with me, my bike is not working, or anything else. It should be ready with your questions. Okay, so now Daniel will read the question 4. Yes, Daniel. Muhammad Daniel. Ahmed Alam.
Yes, ma'am.
Read the question 4.
I'm taking my book.
See, the same thing I said before.
Ma'am, can I do it?
Who is there?
Muhammad Hassan Abid.
Okay, Hassan Abid. Very good, beta. Hassan, read the question.
Question number 4. The rate of exchange between American dollars, Indonesian rupiah, and Singaporean dollars, our US dollar 1 is equal to Singapore.
Okay, so Hassan, just 1 minute. First of all, tell me that US dollar 1 is equal to how much Singaporean dollar?
1.4103.
Singaporean dollar. So if you read the A part of the question, what is the A part of the question? Actually, you have with you US dollar 765 and you want to change into Singaporean dollar.
Yes.
So how you will do that?
US dollars ratio Singaporean dollars.
Okay, very good. It will be US dollar ratio Singaporean dollar. Well and good. Then after that, one US dollar is equal to how much?
1.4103 Singaporean dollars.
4103 Singaporean dollar. Very good. Now, how much US dollar you want to change?
765.
You want to convert into Singaporean dollar? That will be X. So do the cross multiplication and solve the question, beta.
Okay.
X is equal to
1.4103 into 765.
Okay.
Which is equal to $1078.88 Singaporean.
$0.88 Singaporean dollars. Very good. Well done. Full stars. Now the B part of the question. Who want to solve the B part of the question, boys?
Can I?
Who is there?
Zain Ahmed.
Okay, Zain said first. Ahmed, you can say, do after that. Okay, Zain, can you read the B part of the question?
And Indonesian rupee 100 is equal
It's a rupiah. Indonesian rupiah.
Is equal to
2,560,000. How much it is then? 2,560,000 into
Singapore
dollars. Okay, so just read the question at the very beginning and see that what is the ratio, what is the exchange rate given for the rupiah to the Singaporean dollar?
Rupiah, 100 rupiah is equal to 0.0111 Singaporean dollars.
Okay, so can we write that whatever is already given to us, that 100 rupiah is equal to 0.0111 Singaporean dollar, is it?
Yes.
Now you have with you, let's suppose that you have with you 2,560,000 rupiah, Indonesian rupiah, and you want to change it into the Singaporean dollar. How you will do that? It will be X?
Cross.
Okay, then?
100X, 100X is equal to 0.0111 times 2,560,000.
By 2,560,000, what is the answer?
Divide by 100. 28,416
divided by 100. Answer?
Ma'am, it's
284.16. So this is what? Singaporean dollar. Very good. Thank you, Zen. Singaporean dollar. So it means that if you have 2,560,000 Indonesian rupiah, you will get only 284.16 Singaporean dollars. So how low the currency of Indonesia is. Very good, Daniel, full stars. Yes, boys, complete this question, then we will move to the next. And be ready, everyone. I can call anyone for the next. This is the whole question, question number 4. If when you have done with this, then you have to tell me. Then we can, I can continue with the next.
I'm done.
What about the other? Then write the question number 5 on your resistors. You have to write the statement of question 5 on your resistors too. Yes, boys. If you have done so, we can move to the next. Done? Or still solving? I am talking to you, beta. Have you done this or still solving?
Yeah, I have done this. I am writing the next question.
Okay, very good.
I have also done.
Very good. So it's better when you people have done the question, you can raise your hand so I can see how many of you have done and how many of you are left. If you done this question 4, please raise your hand so I can see how many of you have done this question. Very good, boy. Someone joined the class late. Arsalan, you are late today again, beta. Yesterday too, you were late.
Ma'am, I joined in the first 2 minutes.
Arsalan, but when I marking the attendance, you were not there, beta.
Ma'am, maybe I went to drink water like in 5 and I... Maybe, when did you take the attendance? I went to drink water when it was like 5.
I just took the attendance with first 5 minutes.
Yeah, ma'am, I went after to drink first water, five but minutes. I joined very early.
But you were not there even. I can't see your name there.
Am I joined?
Yes, Arsalan, yesterday's I marked your absent and today's absent too. You were not there. Maybe you forget to join the class and you went to drink water.
Oh, ma'am, I joined, I remember.
No, I have checked all the list of the students. You were not there even. And I called your name so many times. Today I'm going to mark your present, but not from tomorrow. Yesterday's absent two marked. And then now only today Faik is absent. And please boys, it will be the same habit. Now I am going to take your attendance after 4 minutes, within 4 to 5 minutes after class starting, I will take your attendance. Whoever will not be there during this time, I will mark the absent. Understand? Okay, question five. Yes, boys, who wants to read the question five? Easy question, the same way, there is no change.
Ma'am, can I?
Hello.
Who said
ma'am,
first?
Can I do?
No, okay, Ahmad Alam, let's start. Ahmad Alam can start, then we can continue with the next. Yes, Ahmad Alam?
Question number five. The rates of exchange between Australian dollars, A dollar, Philippine pesos, Singapore dollars.
First of all, we need the Australian dollars and the Singaporean dollars. So it is mentioned in the question that the Australian dollar 1 is equal to how much Singaporean dollar?
1.0373.
So what, read the A part of the question, Ahmad Alam. How much Singaporean dollar?
Singapore dollar 350 into Australian dollars.
Into Australian dollar.
1.0373
Just wait. Let me give the heading. It will be Australian dollar and Singaporean dollar. Okay, so one Australian dollar is equal to 1.0373 Singaporean dollar. How much Singaporean dollar you have with you?
350.
You want to change into Australian dollar?
Yes.
Okay, do the cross multiplication and tell me the answer.
Okay.
1.0373x is equal to 1 by 350. So that will be 350 only. Now, how you can find out the value of x? 350 by 1.0373. Divide and tell me the answer of this question.
Ma'am, 337.41441.
This is what?
337.41.
So what is this? These are the Australian dollars?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, this is Australian.
Okay. So very good. Very good, Ahmad Alam, for this question. Then who is the next to solve the second part where the other currency is given to you? Please copy this question first, then we will move to the second part of this one.
Sir.
Ma'am, I have done.
Yes, now please raise your hand down. Keep your hand down. I want to see that how many of you have done this part. This is for the previous one. Now, who has done the A part of this question? Good, very good.
Ma'am, do we also have to do question number 6 of this exercise?
Yes, beta, we have to do. So this is a 5B. Go for 5B. Who want to solve the B part of this same question?
Ma'am,
can I do?
Okay, who said first? He can continue. B part is you have the Singaporean dollar this time with you. Singaporean dollar 5,670 and you have to change into?
Philippine pesos.
Okay, so what is the sign of Philippine pesos?
Ma'am, it's a P with two lines.
P with two lines, ratio Singaporean dollar. Okay, is it some exchange rate is given to you in the question?
Yes, ma'am.
100 pesos?
Is equals to 2.8250 Singaporean dollars.
8250 Singaporean dollar. Okay, now what you have with you? Singaporean dollar again?
Yes, 5670 and
zero. Okay. You have to shift into the Filipino pesos. Okay. So convert it quickly.
Ma'am, 5670 into 100.
We can write it as 2.8250x. 100 into 5670. Okay. So 2.8250x is equal to how much?
567,000.
567 and triple zeros over. How you will find out the value of x?
We will divide it by 2.8250.
It's 5,67,000. So 5,67,000, if you divide by 2.8250, so what will be your value?
200,708.
This is Filipino pesos. Yes, Philippine pesos. This is the answer of your B part. Now, the last question of this exercise is left. If you have done with this, then we can go to the last question.
Ma'am, we have to write the question for question number 6.
Yes, beta. Because if you will not write the question, then it will be, I think so there is a problem to solve the questions. If the statement is in front of you, then you will see that whatever is given, because every time when you are revising the questions, you are not opening the book. So it's better to write the question on a register. How many of you are writing the questions? Yesterday also I asked.
Ma'am, I am.
I write, ma'am.
Ma'am, I do.
It's better to write the question, okay? Question number 6. Yes, who want to solve question 6? Yes, boys. Arsalan, did you solve yesterday question? Arsalan? Again, he is out of place. Arsalan, are you there at your place? Muhammad Arsalan? No, definitely no. Muhammad Kundi, read the question, beta.
Ma'am, I don't have the book with me right now.
Where is your book?
Okay, ma'am.
Quickly, go and bring your book. How you can take the class without the book and without your resistor, without your pen, scale, pencil, calculator? There is a 10-minute break. 10 minutes break means we are giving you 10 minutes to arrange your stuff for the next class. Quickly, beta.
Ma'am, I brought my book.
Okay. Page 137. Question number 6.
Okay, ma'am. Couple travels from New Zealand to Singapore for a holiday to celebrate.
A couple travel from New Zealand to Singapore for a holiday to celebrate their Silver Jubilee wedding anniversary. Yes, they are from New Zealand. They went to Singapore. When they went to Singapore, they are having at that time, at the beginning, they are having their, with them New Zealand dollar 3200 when they travel to Singapore. Yes.
At the rate of New Zealand $100 is equal to Singaporean $94.85. They spent
Wait. $94.85. So there is a couple who is from the New Zealand. They went to the Singapore to celebrate their wedding anniversary. And what happened that when they went to the Singapore, they are having the 3200 New Zealand dollar with them. When they went to Singapore, there is the exchange rate is 100 New Zealand dollar is equal to 94.85 New Zealand dollar. So because they want to spend their money into the Singapore, that's why they want to convert the exchange the currency into the New Zealand dollar. So exchange here. Yes, Mohammed Kundi, we will exchange the New Zealand dollar ratio Singaporean dollar. So can you tell me whatever is already given in the question? 100 equal to?
$94.85.
Now how much New Zealand dollar they are having with them?
$3,200 New Zealand dollars.
Okay, convert it into the Singapore dollar.
Okay, ma'am, we will cross multiply. So 100x is equal to 94.85 times 3200.
Okay, multiply.
Ma'am, 3520.
Okay, 3520. So when you divide it by 100, which value you are getting?
Ma'am, 335.2.
335.2 Singaporean dollar. It means that they are having actually with them total 3200 New Zealand dollar, but because they went to the Singapore, so they need to exchange the currency into Singaporean dollar. When they exchange the currency, so they received the $30.35.2, $3,035. Now, what happened next? Yes. Who will complete the question? Arsalan came back or no? Arsalan? No. Ashar?
Yes, ma'am.
Ashar, read the question after that. When they exchange the currency.
Okay, ma'am. They spent a total of 2560.20 in Singapore and convert the remaining Singapore dollars into New Zealand dollars.
Okay, just wait. So what happened that when they came to Singapore, they exchanged the money. So they have the total money 3035. But they spent 2560 from that and for some decimals too. So we have to find out the remaining money first of all. Remaining Singaporean dollar. How much they have right now with them after spending something?
Ma'am, you will minus the two values, right?
Yes. Singapore dollars. That this is the total what they have when they came to the Singapore. 3035.2. How much they spend?
Ma'am, they spent 2560.20. So left will be 475.
Now left will be 475 Singaporean dollar. Now their holidays are over. They want to go back to their country, New Zealand. So it means now they have to exchange again this leftover money to the New Zealand dollars.
Yes, ma'am.
This time the rate of exchange is different. Can you see the new rate of exchange?
Yes, ma'am. It's $100 equal to Singaporean 97.65.
Okay, now this time the 100 New Zealand dollar is equal to 97.65. The ratio is changed. So how much Singaporean dollar they have right now with them before going back?
475.
So they want to convert into New Zealand dollars. Convert it.
Yes, ma'am.
97.65x is equal to 475 multiplied by 100.
Ma'am, it will be 47,500.
And how much will be the value of x?
And then we will divide this with 97.65 and the value will be 486.43.
So the value will be 486.43.
This is which New
dollars?
New Zealand
dollars. This is New Zealand dollars because they want to go back to their home country. So they want to exchange the money again with the New Zealand dollars. Yes, boys. Any question? Very good. Thank you so much. Yes, again, the question was, actually, this question six was, well, a couple went to some other country. They are from New Zealand. They went to the Singapore. But at that time, when they went to the Singapore, they have 3,200 New Zealand dollar with them because they went to Singapore. They have to exchange the money. They exchanged and the money is total $3,035 Singaporean dollar. They spent there when they were during their time there, they spent 2,560.2 and the remaining money is this much because now they want to go back to their country. So they want to exchange again it to the New Zealand dollars. So that time the rate of exchange is different. So they will get this type of this money to go back to their country. Yes, my dear. Any question?
No, ma'am.
Yes, boys. Is this exercise is 100% clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt? Any confusion?
No, ma'am. No doubt. No.
No, ma'am.
No? Okay. So actually, we have one worksheet also along with the not related to this lesson. This lesson I also have. So when you want to solve the worksheet just now after the class, after the this chapter, or you want to solve the worksheet during the revision period,
ma'am, you can
in revision,
yes, ma'am.
Okay, no problem. So, today you just have to compare your previous worksheet, and inshallah, tomorrow we are going to start the new chapter. Allah Hafiz.